We finally have some good news for Artifact. In a post titled State of the Beta, the devs talked a little bit about what they have done so far, what they are doing, and what they will do. Let's check it out. They start by doing a quick recap of the beta so far. So they talk about the experiments with multicolor cards, multicolor casting rules, the factions, shop rules, how to simplify the shop UI, ranked play, hero demo puzzles, and more. And after that, they are going to talk about where are we going. So here they're very careful. They're talking about how they're still testing things, how they are still experimenting, and how there are some things that need to be in place before we're ready to enter a major growth phase for the game. They're going to invite people who are not on the beta yet, specifically people who applied for the beta but have not played Artifact 1. Before entering this major growth phase of the game, they mentioned some things that they need to do before. Things such as a clear way to learn to play the game, like tutorials, card demo puzzles, informative UI. The second, learning game strategy should be fun and players should have a long runway available before being thrown into the shark tank. So they're going to improve bot play, they're going to make progression for playing with friends versus bots, and they're also going to make a clear unlocking progression for hero draft. The next point that they mentioned is how the gameplay should be relatively stable and not constantly changing, as players are trying to learn the game. So they should be largely done with the game-changing rules experiments before they start to invite new players and start this major growth phase. This does not mean they're going to stop changing cards, but they're going to get to a point where it's less frequent and more often bundled together in larger patches. The next point is how they're going to add more game modes to bridge the gap between the relatively lighter experience of Hero Draft and the heavier experience of Constructed. So here they're going to mention some focused playtest events, ephemera events, and also an advanced Hero Draft, which is the most likely candidate, but it's still not clear if it's the old draft that we had in Artifact 1 or if it's a new iteration, a new version of draft. Finally, the game should be both functional and fun to look at, and that means final card art, beautiful animations and effects, beautiful board, and effects that serve a functional purpose, conveying what their cards are doing in the resulting game state. And I love that. Finally, what's the roadmap? So next week they are going to start putting the tutorial beta 2.0 for the current players, and they are going to test with the current players for a few weeks before starting to invite players who have not played Artifact 1. So, in mid to late January, they are going to start letting players invite their friends as the main way of inviting new players while they continue to iterate on all the goals that they mentioned earlier. They also say that, quote, "We expect we are a few months away from slowing down constant changes to cards, game rules, and balance. At that point, we expect to spend more of an effort on UI, UX, and all the many features listed above on the road to open beta and eventual release." So this is important here, and be careful not to confuse it. They are not saying that the rules are set in stone yet. They are saying that they are going to experiment a little bit, and only when they finish these experiments, they are going to start getting into the growth phase of the game. That's when they're going to start inviting more people, specifically with the open beta. They also mentioned that the open beta is far enough away that it would be a disservice to try to pin down a date right now. We know what we need to do before then, but for now, it's still one foot in front of the other until the game is ready for it. So they don't know yet for how long these experiments are going to be. Finally, the best part of the post, a glimpse of the future. First of all, we have here some simpler and smaller card designs. Remember, this is just concept, this is not final yet. But in this version here, we cannot see exactly where the items would go, right? And it looks a little bit cleaner and smaller too. Now to my favorite image of this post. Here we have a lot to unpack, so let's start. First of all, we have the timers, which are present in the game, but they don't look like this. These ones here look very good in comparison. We also have different towers. The tower design is different, and the colors too. We have here the bluish version for the Radiant and the reddish version for Dire. We also see Lion that is not present in Artifact 2.0, but probably is going to come back soon. We also have here the new coin buttons, which are being replaced for these blue and red orbs, which look very good. We also can see our beautiful Lux and Nox. They are back. I know Anger Mania hates them, but I love them. Another head scratcher here is this Siege Engine with apparently 10 HP or 10 attack or 10 armor or 10 something else, which seems to be a unit, but apparently it's not exactly on the battlefield, so it's a little bit different from what we are used to seeing, so we don't know yet exactly what it does. And finally the board, which is a little bit different from what we have today. In the last part of the post, they show us some of the new final card arts, and they show us Tiny, Quicksap Sproutling, Vanessa, Morphling Whelp, these Eidolons, Nyx, Berserker of the Abyssum, Tusk, and the Slumbering Brute. And here is everyone's new wallpaper that they have also shared in this post. We can see here on the bottom left that we have a different color design for the logo of Artifact, right? And I think I like this very much. It looks new, it looks different, it looks simple, and I really, really like it. What about you? Tell me in the comments. And this is going to be it for today's post. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.